Our next tech toy takes us to the small Central European country of Croatia, where a new supercar is capturing attention and turning heads around the world. With its sleek styling and cutting-edge technology, the Rimac Concept 1 is a bold statement about the future of both electric cars and the people who make them. Rimac Automobili is based near Zagreb. The capital of a country known more for postcard-perfect views along the Adriatic than automobile manufacturing. At least, until now. Tech Toys 360 talks with Mate Rimac about the Concept 1's technology.
This is the Rimac Concept 1. It's the first electric supercar. We have developed it to be the best supercar, not just a supercar with an electric motor.
Creating a new electric supercar comes with many challenges.
The company is based in Croatia. It's not really a country which is famous for high technology or for car industry. So we had really to build all the know-how and the knowledge from ground up. We couldn't hire people from the car industry, so we had to re-engineer everything.
The lightweight carbon fiber body envelops an innovative powertrain created specifically for the Concept 1. This is no adaptation. It's a precisely engineered propulsion system designed to provide the speed and range of a traditional combustion engine. This is where Rimac is blazing trails. How? The Concept 1 uses not one motor, but four. One for each wheel. Now that's power. So charge up and go.
The special thing about the car is that we have four electric motors, permanent magnet, oil-cooled, so we can control each wheel separately with its own motor. So within a corner, we can control each wheel 1,000 times per second in both directions, either accelerating or braking.
Four motors, with inverters and reduction gearboxes for each wheel, churn out enough energy to thrust this wonder car at speeds approaching 190 miles per hour. This tech toy delivers technology in spades. Performance and power work harmoniously together. Using Rimac's all-wheel torque vectoring system, the driver designs the driving experience.
The most special thing about the car is the torque vectoring system. The driver can decide between an oversteer setup, understeer, or a neutral setup of the car. That means you have more cars in one. If you are a more confident driver who knows how to drive, he can choose the oversteer setup and slide through the corners. The car will help him to do so. But if you are a little bit afraid of the high power of the car and want to drive safely, you can choose an understeer setup and the car will behave very safe and anyone can drive.
An onboard touchscreen interface provides a range of options for taking advantage of the Concept 1's muscle. With total output of 1,088 horsepower and 2,800 foot-pounds of torque, the Concept 1 is one serious contender. It's a beast of an automobile, generating serious power.
The acceleration of the car is 2.8 seconds from 0 to 60 miles an hour. We have limited the top speed to 305 kilometers an hour because of the power consumption, but it could be much faster if we would unleash it.
A lithium-phosphate battery pack comprised of 1,400 cells powers the Concept 1 and produces an amazing 92 kilowatt-hours of electricity. That gives the 3,600-pound Concept 1 a range of over 370 miles, the best in its class by a mile, or many a miles.
I started to design the technology behind the car in my garage. I wanted to make an electric race car. That's how it started. So the idea from the beginning was to make a powertrain system which can beat any combustion engine.
With rapid charging capabilities, this machine is back on the road in less than an hour after plug-in. The cabin tailors itself perfectly around the driver, while the high-end infotainment system entertains and informs the driver of the vehicle systems. The tail lights have a deep 3D tunnel effect and animated indicators for more appeal. Rimac's groundbreaking four-motor technology catapults automotive technology to the next stratosphere. One can take its title for a cool million. Well, make that $980,000. But who's counting pennies?